First, select the pump. In the Properties palette, notice that currently the pump has no P&ID tag set, so it will use the shared parameter that the P&ID tag property has been mapped to. Let's map the P&ID tag property to P-1005. Right-click the line number element and click Map to Existing. Notice the tag is automatically populated with the line number. If there's a change to the P&ID, the next time you upload the plant model to the cloud, you'll see an indication in Revit. For example, if the value of the tag in the P&ID changes from P-1005 and the model is uploaded to the cloud, Revit makes you aware of the change. To demonstrate this, in the Properties palette, let's change the P&ID tag value to P-0001. Notice that it's still highlighted, but the status has changed from green to yellow to indicate that there is a mismatch between the Revit model and the original P&ID. Revit detects and displays a warning when there's an open connection or if there's a mismatch between the parts in the P&ID drawing and the Revit model. For now, let's change the value back to reconcile the mismatch. Next, let's start a modeling line. First, switch to a floor plan view. You can start with any part in the pipeline, so let's begin with this line segment. You'll notice that the size, system type, and the pipe type are automatically set. The offset or elevation is the only thing that needs to be defined. Let's set it to 15 feet. Add the pipe segment from the heat exchanger to the pump. As you create the 3D model for the P&ID, Revit tracks which lines are complete and which are still in progress. Next, switch to a 3D view to place the valves. As you do this, you'll discover that order is important. The P&ID lists the pump, then the check valve, and then the gate valve, and then the heat exchanger. Let's start by placing the check valve. Next, place the gate valve. Notice the warning indicating that there's a mismatch. Because they are out of order, the status has changed from green to gray. Let's undo the placement of the gate valve. This time, we'll place the gate valve where it is supposed to go, which is on the other side of the check valve. Notice the status changes to green because now everything is consistent between the Revit model and the P&ID. The only thing that is missing is the mapping for the heat exchanger. To demonstrate the change in status for this line, let's undo the last step. Notice the blue circle when the pipeline is incomplete. When you click Redo, it changes to green. The only thing remaining is to map the endpoint. Let's map E1007 to the heat exchanger to complete this pipeline. We are ready to move on to another line. Click the icon with the three dots to the right of the pipeline number to display a list of all the line numbers. Double-click on line 1061 to open it. You can continue with the same process to model this line. This time, let's work in a section view. Let's start with the vessel and add a pipe. Notice that as you start to model, the connector dialog prompts you to select which connector to use. In this case, two connectors were available in that location. Now draw the pipe, align it to the outlet, and click on the vessel to connect into it. Next, place the gate valve. Notice the indicator that displays if the valve is not fully connected. Let's switch back to a 3D view and try placing the gate valve again. Now it's fully connected. For the vessel, we're going to map the one from the P&ID to the existing one in the model. Notice that the yellow slashed bar is telling me that the mapping is set up differently from what is currently defined in the model. This means that the current family name doesn't match the one that's defined. To correct this, open the P&ID settings dialog and check the object mapping for the equipment. Click Object Mapping and click the Equipment tab. Let's add another type of vessel to match one that's in the model. Click the plus sign to add a row. For P&ID class name, select Vessel. For Revit family, select the correct Revit family. Alternatively, you could have just changed the existing value for the vessel. Doing it this way demonstrates how you can have multiple different families mapped to the same P&ID class. Notice the status bar changes back to green. You can continue to make modifications and even delete pipe elements. Notice the water droplet next to the line segment indicates that there is a disconnection in the pipeline. You can also change the routing of the pipe. When the pipeline is complete, the status changes back to green. You can continue to use Revit P&ID Modeler to model other lines from this P&ID. P&ID Modeler streamlines the process for modeling P&IDs in Revit and ensures consistency between the P&ID and the Revit model.